I'm keeping busy, sir. Don't mind me, please.
Thank you. Our Royal Highness has never complained about it before.
I'm sorry, but Mr. Ingram, who is the Royal
Highness? Carl Ingram, Providence partner and brass balls billionaire. A legendary political fixer, Ingram is old money and as rotten as they come.
Power can be kept by only a few good men.
And I'll probably get a warning about that.
Women. We might be the chess masters, but we need our chess pieces to keep the balance. And like all the great chess masters of our time, patience is the key. This is the fundamental rule when recruiting.
For us. Little do they know that there's a war going on.
And who might you be?
Because
I don't know you. Hey. Yeah,
psycho! Zero copy. I have one down here.
Free Excel. Lo and behold, he started to gain, scholarship. Soon to be, admitted. School that his parents could afford.
What's up?
This is Rogue One Action. The fast guard.
Echo 6-2, disengage.
I understand.
Play games? Huh? Okay, you got it.
Hey! Come out wherever you are.
We're green.
I'm giving you a chance to back down nice and easy.
It's best that you vacate this area. Please leave in an orderly fashion.
Exactly why the work of unknowns is so important. Ah!
visual! Lost visual! Anyone got eyes on Tango? Negative on the visual!
Thank you.
that's your winning face, I'd hate to see you lose.
We underestimated the Constant.
Yeah, he's a glorified desk clerk.
He's not just after the money. He wants it all.
We caught him once, we can do it again. And, well, we're not the ones who let him escape.
You still don't trust her.
I don't like executive decision makers. Look, you don't have to follow her, you know? Soon, this will be over. Maybe it's time to think about the future. You have to face the possibility that there's no going back. If the ICA knows what you did...
She'll make it right. She always does.
We have a fix on Carlisle. Come on. We've got a plane to catch. I hope you like the rain, 47.
Miss Burnwood.
How did you...
I have everyone's number. You really ought to know by now.
You planned this? All of it?
Don't be silly. I just played the hand I was dealt.
We'll find you.
You had me. Where'd that get you?
We handed you an empire.
It's for the best. The partners were complacent, set in their ways. But power is more than just security. Providence can be an agent of change. Surely you understand. Or you will. Soon enough.
she came home.
Carlyle's lost an empire. You fall hard enough, you tend to be reminded of what truly matters. So, the end of the line. You ready for this?
Are you? Who will you be without a score to settle?
I guess the world's most wanted fugitive will have to do.
Alexa Carlyle is dead, according to the funeral invitation, that is. So naturally, it caused quite a stir when the late matriarch turned up at the breakfast table, alive and kicking. Carlyle, wisely sensing that her number is up, has emerged from exile to tie up loose ends and secure the Carlyle legacy. She may be a monster, but you have to admire her due diligence. Carlyle descends from an ancient line of warrior aristocrats. Her great-grandfather made a killing in the Second Opium War and established an empire in shipping, railroads, and newspaper publishing. While largely unknown to the public, the family still asserts its quiet dominance over global transport and logistics, media, and technology. Most senior of the partners, Alexa Carlyle, is cold as ice, tough as nails, and sharp as a razor. Incidentally, it was her late father who first brought the three families together after the end of World War II at this very house, meaning that this gentleman is the birthplace of Providence.
It began here, and it ends here. Talk about poetic.
One more thing. According to our intel, Carlyle keeps a case file on the Constant, information that may be helpful in his recapture, so don't leave the estate without it.
Right. Happy hunting, 47. See you on the other side.
Thank you.
Thornbridge Manor, the Carlyle family's home for countless generations. The Revenant Alexa Carlyle and her three adult children, younger brother Zachary, grandson, and daughter-in-law, are all gathered to conduct Carlyle's sham funeral. Curiously, Carlyle summoned a famous London PI soon after arriving this morning, but his purpose at Thornbridge is yet unclear. Now, the target knows that you're coming, and her guard detail is top-notch. So Mr. Gray will secure their nearby field HQ and intercept all calls going in and out of the estate. Any appeal for backup is going to fall on very deaf ears. Good luck, gentlemen.
Phineas Whitmer, private investigator. I have an appointment with Madame Carlyle.
Please wait.
Mr. Whitmer is here to see Madame Carlyle.
Sir, I'm afraid you don't have the right clearance.
That is Phineas Release Whitmer, the famous private investigator, hired by Madame Carlyle this morning. Curious where he's going. Maybe you should do some detecting yourself, 47.
Took one out! Alpha team, flank left! Bravo team, cover fire!
Mr. Whitmer, thank God you're here. Can I take you to Madame Carlyle?
Yes, please.
If you'd follow me. I know I oughtn't say anything, but I'm so relieved you're here. Everything's just so strange. Preparing for Madame's funeral, and then she turns up alive. But then the awful business with her brother Zachary, and all this security. I've never seen the place guarded like this, and I dare say I don't like it at all. This is what I mean. You have to be patted down before you see Madame Carlyle inside.
Hello there, sir.
Oh, I could just cry.
If you want to pass, you need to comply to a frisk, sir. Sir, you do not have clearance. Turn around right now.
Mr. Whitmer,
I have already told you this is off limits.
A great tragedy has fallen upon us, and I need a...
What's wrong with you? You're gonna get yourself shot! That's good, sir. Keep going.
I need to get a listing of asset transfers from the Carlisle account, HTC depot number 5085. No, I need it immediately. Yes, I'll do it. Yes, I'm still here. It doesn't exist. What do you mean it doesn't exist? Right. I'll double check and get back to you.
Hey, you are trespassing.
Okay, drop it.
Oh.
I'm not sure I know who you...
You lunatic! Knocking people out like that.
I need help! Someone, for Christ's sake!
Whoa.
What are you waiting for?
Yeah.
This all confirms that Arthur Edwards stole everything from Madame Carlyle. Perhaps you should let her know how bad it is, 47.
Thank you.
That's Madame Carlyle taken care of. Time to get the file on Arthur Edwards.